Well, the Congress has slammed the center's mega outreach drive in Jammu and Kashmir. Congress MPs Gulam Nabi Azad as well as Kapil Sibal have claimed that the visit by 36 ministers is fixed, since they will meet only those who are pre-selected by the center. Congress added that the government hid the ground reality from delegations of foreign envoys who had visited the valley so far. It also questioned why the opposition was barred from visiting Kashmir earlier. The visit of ministers reportedly from January 18th to the 24th comes 5 months after the abrogation of Article 370. The ministers will apprise the people on the positive impact of the decision to abrogate Article 370, as well as the developmental measures by the government. Former Chief Minister Omar Abdullah may also be shifted from the Harinivas detention centre to make way for the visiting delegation.
जब वो जाएंगे और किससे मिलेंगे, हमारा जो अनुभव है अभी तक, दो फॉरेन डेलीगेशंस अभी तक गए हैं, कुछ एमपीज और कुछ डिप्लोमेट्स, वो मिलते उन्हीं लोगों से हैं जिनको केंद्रीय सरकार यहाँ से भेजती है या पहले उनको बुलाती है यहाँ और उनको कहती है कि क्या क्या कहना। तो अब और चाहे 20 लोग भेजेंगे उसका कोई अर्थ नहीं,
तो कोई अर्थ नहीं बनता इनकी।
अभी मैं जम्मू कश्मीर ही जा रहा हूं और उसके बाद पता चलेगा।
आवर डियर होम मिनिस्टर हैज बीन सेइंग दैट ऑन एवरी ओकेजन इफ समबडी आस्क्स हिम अ क्वेश्चन एंड ही गोज आउट टू मेक अ स्पीच, ही सेज देयर इज नथिंग, एवरीथिंग इज फाइन, एवरीथिंग इज नॉर्मल, देयर आर नो रिस्ट्रिक्शंस, पीपल कैन मूव अबाउट। सो इफ दैट्स द केस, देन व्हाई इज ही सेंडिंग 36 मिनिस्टर्स टू एक्सप्लेन द पोजीशन ऑफ दिस गवर्नमेंट ओवर आर्टिकल 370 टू द पीपल ऑफ कश्मीर।
भारत सरकार अंतर्राष्ट्रीय दबाव में ये कदम उठा रही है, क्योंकि अंतर्राष्ट्रीय समुदाय का एक प्रेशर है और ह्यूमन राइट्स को लेकर, दूसरी तरफ सुप्रीम कोर्ट का भी निर्देश है कि जो सिविल राइट्स हैं वो दिए जाएं, जो कम्युनिकेशन कंप्लीट, आँख खुली है और उन्होंने अपने मंत्रियों को भेजने का फैसला किया है।
विद द एब्रोगेशन ऑफ 370, द आइडिया इज टू क्रिएट अ लेवल प्लेइंग फील्ड फॉर जम्मू एंड कश्मीर, बी इट द मेट्रोपॉलिटन सिटीज ऑफ मुंबई, चेन्नई, कैलकटा, बैंगलोर, डेवलपमेंट विल टेक प्लेस, एंड इट इज इन दिस एंडेवर दैट वी हैव 30+ मिनिस्टर्स going and discussing the plan on the drawing board and telling the people of Jammu and Kashmir what is their due.
Ashrafani is joining us live from Srinagar with more details on this. Ashraf, you've already got the opposition dismissing this entire visit by these union ministers, saying that it is going to be staged and that it is a sham. Just give us a sense if there are any details at this point on exactly what the itinerary will be for this delegation, and secondly, how this news is being perceived in Jammu and Kashmir.
Akshita, as far as the Kashmir is concerned, there are other problems which had emerged during last 3 days. Valleys cut off from the rest of the world. During last 3 days, there was not a single flight which could land in the Srinagar. And also the road connective which connects the Kashmir Valley with the rest of the world is also blocked due to the heavy snowfall since last 3 days. But today now weather is getting better, and probably the things will come on track back and the life will get normal. But as far as the ministers visited concerned, it was planned by the government that the delegation of ministers in a turn-wise manner will visit Jammu and Kashmir. They are going to start their visit from Jammu. Basically, there is a less problem in the Jammu. It is accessible, and the ministers are visiting one by one to Jammu and visiting different districts. As far as the Kashmir is concerned, here are also charted plans in the coming days that these ministers will be visiting the different districts and will be meeting the district administration, some leaders, some workers and some locals. But so far it does not seem that on to today basis there will be such kind of any this improvement on this, that any minister of the center can land in Srinagar. But the administration is gearing up, because as you know, now almost more than 5 months had passed, the situation is not improving as the government was expecting that it will get better in 4 months. Yesterday it was decided that the broadband services will be restored in the Kashmir Valley. So far they have not been restored. There are some loopholes there, and also some red flags by the security agencies that probably by restoring the internet in the Kashmir Valley, there will be some kind of law and order problem, as there are some intelligence inputs.
Yes.
That is why the government is trying on best to deal the Kashmir situation, but on other things they are facing many many challenges, including the challenge by the current weather here in Kashmir.
So this is essentially going to be an outreach program. These 36 union ministers are going to Kashmir with an aim to send out a message about the difference the abrogation of Article 370 has made. They're also going to be speaking about what steps the government is going to take up to ensure more development is brought into the valley. Ashraf, for the moment, thanks for joining us. And we're continuing to get you all the latest as far as the investigation goes into the disgraced DSP Davinder Singh, who was arrested with two Hizbul Mujahideen terrorists on Saturday. More revelations are now tumbling out. According to sources, a full location map of the Srinagar-based 15 corps of the army has been recovered from his house. Security agencies fear that Hizbul terrorists might have shared the map with their handlers sitting in Pakistan. Now, Davinder's house is located close to the 15 corps based. Agencies also recovered 7.5 lakh rupees cash from his house during the search operation. Meanwhile, a day after Davinder Singh was dismissed from his Jammu and Kashmir police, the administration has stripped Davinder Singh of his state gallantry award. The government has ordered the forfeiture of his Sher-e Kashmir police medal for disloyalty and bringing the force into disrepute.
अगर इस प्रकार की घटनाओं में कोई भी मुलव्वस पाया जाता है तो उनको छोड़ना नहीं चाहिए, उनको सस्पेंड करना चाहिए और मुझे लगता है नौकरी से भी निकालना चाहिए. लेकिन जांच जो चल रही है उससे सारा कुछ निकलने वाला है. ये भी पुलिस ने कहा है कि 6 घटनाओं में वो संलिप्त था, तो मुझे लगता है कि अपने आप में पुलिस जो भी एक्शन लेगी वो ठीक एक्शन लेगी.
Taking this across to Manjeet Sehgal for more details. Manjeet, from what agency sources have told us, you know, the fact that they've recovered a full location map of the 15 corps base in Srinagar, that by itself is a huge worry, because there are questions about exactly who Davinder Singh shared these map details with.
Well, Akshita, it is still not known whom he has shared the details, whether or not he has shared or not, but the Jammu Kashmir police, during the raids which were conducted at various places, particularly in the southern Kashmir, including the house owned by Davinder Singh and his close relatives, it has come to the notice that some incriminating documents have been recovered. The DJP Jammu Kashmir Dilbagh Singh had also yesterday confirmed that incriminating material, including some documents, were recovered from his residence. But sources are telling us that these documents also include a location map of 15 corps. I mean, recovery of a document like this, which is highly sensitive in nature, is a very serious matter. It is being feared that Davinder Singh, with the help of these militants, might have shared sensitive information about army establishments with the enemy. So the investigations are currently on, and the police is conducting raids at various places.
Okay, Manjeet, thanks for getting us that update. Moving on, China has been snubbed by the UNSC after trying to peddle ally Pakistan's propaganda on Kashmir. China sought a closed-door consultation on Kashmir at the UNSC, but the request was rejected by all members of the Security Council, many of whom recognized that Kashmir is a bilateral issue. China sought the meeting based on an old request of Pakistan. Remember, in August last year, a closed-door meet was held on Kashmir on Pakistan's request, but there is no outcome. The development has been welcomed by India, as our envoy to the UN, Saeed Akbaruddin, said that the outcome to the consultation was on expected lines and that Pakistan's propaganda failed.
We are happy that neither the alarmist scenario painted by the representatives of Pakistan nor any of the baseless allegations made repeatedly by various representatives of Pakistan in UN fora were found to be credible. We are glad that it was pointed out by many friends Pakistan's practice of using false pretenses to distract from addressing the malaise that afflicts it has run its course today.
Meanwhile, Chief of Defence Staff General Bipin Rawat lashed out at terror sponsor Pakistan. This was at the Raisina dialogue. He demanded that there be a crackdown on Pakistan by the Financial Task Force.
The future of terrorism is that terrorism is here to stay. So long as there are going to be states that are going to be sponsoring terrorism, so long there are going to be states that are going to use terrorists as their proxies, make weapons available to them, make the funding for them, we cannot control terrorism. And therefore, what is the final end state that we wish to arrive at? We have to bring an end to terrorism, and that can only happen the way the Americans started after 9/11. They said, let's go on a spree on global war on terror and let the nations join together and fight terrorism together. Well, to do that, what do? You have to isolate the terrorists. Anybody who's sponsoring terrorism has to be taken to task. You cannot have partners who are partnering with you in the global war on terror and yet sponsoring proxies and terror.
You're referring to Pakistan.
I'm referring to any country which is sponsoring terror.
Yes. How do you deal with a problem like Pakistan?
Yeah, therefore the problem with this is you have to have an international messaging that has to go to them, hard action being taken. And I feel one of the measures that has been adopted is blacklisting by the FATF is one good measure. Diplomatic isolation. You have to do this. You have to bring about acceptability in the nation that yes, they are sponsors of terrorism. Denial of terrorism, to say that they are not denying it, they are themselves victim of terrorism, cannot continue for on and on. And I think we have to get the bull by these horns.
Moving on, Congress MP Adhiranjan Chaudhary has sparked a fresh controversy while speaking at a public rally in West Bengal's North 24 Paragana's. An angry Adhiranjan Chaudhary declared himself to be a Pakistani citizen. Adhir's declaration came after the BJP accused him of towing Pakistan's line by questioning the authenticity of last year's Pulwama terror strike. Now, the controversial Congress MP also dared the government to act against him. Adhiranjan Chaudhary slammed the nationalism debate and said that India is not the property of Prime Minister Narendra Modi and Home Minister Amit Shah.
যে আমাকে পাকিস্তানি সাজানো হলো তো আজকে আমি জবাবে বললাম হ্যাঁ আমি পাকিস্তানি তো জাপানিজ করে নিলাম এখানে হ্যাঁকে হ্যাঁ বললে বিপদ হ্যাঁকে হ্যাঁ বললে দেশদ্রোহী হতে হয় এ কোন দেশে বস করছি আমরা ভারতবর্ষে হ্যাঁকে হ্যাঁ বলার উপায় নাই দিনকে দিন বলার উপায় নাই রাতকে রাত বলার উপায় নাই ওই দিল্লির রাঙ্গা বিল্লা মোদি আর অমিত শাহ যা বলবো আমাদের তাই মেনে নিতে হবে আমরা পারবো না মানতে এই ভারতবর্ষ নরেন্দ্র মোদী অমিত শাহের বাপের জমিদারি নয় হিন্দুস্তান কিসি কি বাপ কা জাগির নেই হ্যায়
Manogya Loyal is joining us live from Kolkata with more details on this. Manogya, Adhiranjan Chaudhary is not really new to controversy, is he? He's been known for making some very, very extreme statements. But the fact that he was actually referring to BJP, accusing him of towing the Pakistan line, he perhaps took it too far when he declared that he himself is a Pakistani.
Well, he's escalated the national and anti-national debate by, of course, alleging that BJP holds anyone anti-national once they state or make a statement against the Prime Minister or the Home Minister. The words and the phrases that he's used in this speech itself speaks volumes about what he's been saying. The fact that now he says that it might not be on the same lines as I wanted to say, which is being interpreted. But the reality is that he has hit out at BJP once more. Not just on the party, but also that the central government for making policies and, of course, following certain kind of rules and regulations that haven't been going down well with the opposition on the political lines. But when you talk about hitting out in public, well, this is one of those fiery speeches where he's not just mentioned and taken on the central government the way he wants to and the, on the Congress lines, but also used words that haven't been heard from him in the past.
That's right. And perhaps the Congress will have to respond to, of course, the charge and clarify perhaps on what Adhiranjan Chaudhary has said when he's declared that, yes, he's a Pakistani citizen. Manogya, thanks for joining us with those details. We're slipping into a short break here on Lunch Break. Coming up on the other side. Welcome back. Well, after receiving flak for linking underworld don Karim Lala to Congress, Shiv Sena MP Sanjay Raut has now clarified saying that the context was completely misinterpreted. Rawat said that Karim Lala was the minister of the Pathan community in Mumbai, so many politicians used to visit him. He further said that he's always shown respect towards Indira Gandhi despite being in opposition. Speaking in Pune on January 15th, Rawat had said that the former Prime Minister Indira Gandhi used to visit underworld don Karim Lala in Mumbai. He even said that gangsters like Dawood Ibrahim, Chota Shakil used to decide who would be the police commissioner of Mumbai and who would sit in government. Following Rawat's claim, Congress's Milind Deora cautioned Sanjay Rawat of showing restraint before distorting the legacies of deceased prime ministers. The BJP IT cell head Amit Malviya taunted Rahul Gandhi, asking if he'll speak up against ally Shiv Sena.
Maine hamesha Indira Gandhi, Pandit Nehru, Rajiv Gandhi, Gandhi parivar ke bare mein jitna maine respect opposition mein hote hue bhi dikhaya, utna aur kisi ne dikhaya nahi. Jab jab Indira Gandhi par hamla kiya hai logon ne, tab tab main Indira Gandhi ji ki bhumika lekar khada raha hu. Jo aap tweet bid kar rahe hain na, aap unko bata dijiye. मैंने ये कहा था कल, उस वक्त की बात, मुंबई की बात चल रही थी, कि मुंबई में किस तरह का माहौल था. करीम लाला से बहुत लोग मिलने आते थे, राजनीतिक. उसके घर में सबके फोटो लगाए हुए थे. देखिए उस वक्त का माहौल अलग था. करीम लाला पख्तून हिंद नाम की एक संगठन थी, पठानों के वो नेता थे.
And let's listen into exactly what the Shiv Sena MP Sanjay Rawat had said earlier on Indira Gandhi that triggered that controversy.
जी तुम्ही आता नाव घेता है, मतलब दाऊद इब्राहिम असेल, बरं का छोटा शकील असेल, शरद शेट्टी होता, हे सगळे लोक ह्यांच्या हातामध्ये मुंबई आणि आसपासचा भाग होता. ते ठरवायचे मुंबईत काय होणार, पोलीस कमिशनर कोण होणार, मंत्रालयात कोण बसणार. हाजी मस्तान जेव्हा मंत्रालयात जायचं तो अख्खं मंत्रालय त्याला घ्यायला खाली यायचं, मी पाहिलेलं आहे, हे मी पाहिलेलं आहे. हा करीम लाला होता, त्याला भेटायला इंदिरा गांधी जायच्या पायधुणीला, हे अंडरवर्ल्ड आम्ही पाहिलं आहे. हे आता काही नाही, आता किरकोळ लोक आहेत.
Mustafa Sheikh is joining us live from Mumbai with more details on this. Mustafa, the fact that Sanjay Rawat has come out to clarify, saying that he respects the Gandhis, immediately reeks of damage control. And the fact is that perhaps Congress is miffed with the ally Shiv Sena over this kind of comments.
Well, clearly Sanjay Rawat doesn't backtrack on his comments, and the need that he thought of clarifying these particular comments goes to show that there are political repercussions, and the calls from his party leadership he must have got as to how this entire comment of his is being considered and with reference to Indira Gandhi and hurting Congress. So these are clearly clarification by the Sanjay Rawat, but the damage has already been done. The jury is out to basically seek answers whether Indira Gandhi really met Karim or not, what was the situation then, and then to cast aspersions on the Congress party. This is something of an ammunition for the BJP to corner Congress and the Maha Agadi government in Maharashtra. Back to you.
That's right. Mustafa, thanks for getting us those details. The Congress so far, only a reaction from Milind Deora, where he'd cautioned Sanjay Rawat, and now the Shiv Sena MP clarifying, saying that he has great respect and regard for the government.